Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jumper.
Basically, you start out with massive amounts of data. You say, how are we going to analyze this? Well, let's fire up a pivot table and see if we can solve this problem.
Welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Challen. I've got an amazing trick for you today. I still can't believe that it works. Now, let's do a quick bit of review. You know how to do a spearing formula, right? A 3D formula. You can see here I have worksheets from January through December. If I want to add up cell B3 on all of those sheets equals sum, and then Jan, colon, December, exclamation point, B3, press enter, and it spears right through those worksheets and adds up January through December. All right, that's great, provided you have some contiguous worksheets. Let me show you another section I set up here. So take a look at these worksheets. Andy ABC, Andy sales of product DEF, Andy sales of XYZ, and then we start over. Bob ABC, Bob DEF, Bob XYZ, Charlie ABC, Charlie, right? What if we have to add up all the ABCs? Well, that's going to be a little bit of a pain, you would think, but check this out. Equal sum apostrophe. And then I'm going to do star ABC, closing apostrophe, the exclamation point, and B3. All right, now, when I press enter, Microsoft is going to rewrite this formula pointing at each individual ABC. So you see how I entered it, star ABC, that's in apostrophes, the bang, the B3. And when we go back and look at the formula, look at what it did. It actually went through and figured out all the sheets that had something ABC. We could also do this equals sum apostrophe Bob star apostrophe B4, and it will grab all three Bob sheets. Absolutely amazing. Great way to write very cool 3D spearing formulas that don't touch contiguous worksheets. Well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.
Well, thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.